We're given a rational function and asked to determine the y-intercept, x-intercepts, vertical asymptotes, and horizontal asymptotes. When working with rational functions, it's often helpful to have the numerator and denominator in factored form. So let's start by factoring both the top and bottom. Looking at the numerator, the factors of 2x squared are 2x and x. The second positions must come from the factors of negative 5, so that the sum of the inner product and outer product is equal to negative 9x. So if we use a factor of negative 5 here, minus 5, that would give us negative 10x. The other factor of negative 5 is positive 1. So negative 10x plus 1x is equal to negative 9x, so that's factored correctly. And now for the denominator, we'd have a factor of 2x and x here. Now we use the factors of negative 3 in the second positions, so the sum of the inner and outer product is equal to positive 5x. So if we use a factor of positive 3 here and minus 1 here, we have positive 6x plus negative 1x is equal to 5x. So now we'll start by finding the y-intercept. To find the y-intercepts of any function, we set x equal to 0. And because this is written in function notation, that means we need to evaluate f of 0. So whether we use the original form or the factored form, it doesn't matter. If we use the original form, if x is 0, we would have 0 minus 0 minus 5, or negative 5, divided by 0 plus 0 minus 3, or negative 3. This result would be the same if we use the factored form as well. This simplifies to positive 5/3, which means our y-intercept is the point with an x-coordinate of 0 and a y-coordinate of positive 5/3. To find the x-intercepts of a function, we set y equal to 0, or the function value equal to 0. But because we have a rational function, as long as there aren't any common factors between the numerator and denominator, this function will only equal 0 when the numerator is equal to 0. To show why this is true, we'll set f of x equal to 0 and then solve for x. So we would have 0 equals, in factored form, the quantity 2x plus 1 times the quantity x minus 5, all over the quantity 2x minus 1 times the quantity x plus 3. So because this is a fraction, if we put 0 over 1, it's still equal to 0, and now we could solve by cross multiplying. But notice when we cross multiply, we would have 1 times the numerator is equal to 0 times the denominator, which would just give us the equation, the numerator equals 0. So as long as there aren't any common factors between the numerator and denominator, the x-intercepts can be found by setting the numerator equal to 0. 2x plus 1 is equal to 0 when x equals negative 1/2, and x minus 5 is equal to 0 when x equals 5. So we have two x-intercepts. They're the points negative 1/2, comma 0, and 5, 0. Now to determine the vertical asymptotes of a rational function, again, as long as there aren't any common factors between the numerator and denominator, the values of x that make the denominator equal to 0 give us the equations of the vertical asymptotes. So we can find the vertical asymptotes by setting the quantity 2x minus 1 times the quantity x plus 3 equal to 0. If there are common factors between the numerator and denominator, the zeros of the common factors give us holes, not x-intercepts or vertical asymptotes. So 2x minus 1 is equal to 0 when x equals positive 1/2, and x plus 3 is equal to 0 when x equals negative 3. Remember, vertical asymptotes are vertical lines, so the equations of the vertical asymptotes are x equals 1/2 and x equals negative 3. And now for the last question, we're asked to determine the horizontal asymptotes, which is really asking us to determine the end behavior or long-run behavior of a rational function. So there is a nice shortcut to determining if the function has horizontal asymptotes, and if it does, what they are. We can determine the horizontal asymptotes by determining the degree of the numerator and denominator. Notice the numerator is degree 2, and the denominator is also degree 2. The rule is, if the degree of the numerator and denominator are the same, the equation of the horizontal asymptote is y equals the ratio of the leading coefficients, which in this case would be 2 over 2. So if we have y equals 2 over 2, that's equal to 1. So the equation of the horizontal asymptote is y equals positive 1. Remember, it's a horizontal line, so it's in the form of y equals a constant. And just to review the other possibilities when determining a horizontal asymptote, if the degree of the numerator is less than the degree of the denominator, then the horizontal asymptote is y equals 0. If the degrees are equal, as in our case, the horizontal asymptote is y equals the ratio of the leading coefficients. And the third case is, if the degree of the numerator is greater than the degree of the denominator, then there is no horizontal asymptote. So this comes in very handy when determining horizontal asymptotes. As a last step, let's go ahead and graph the function and check our work. This might be a little hard to see, but we do have a y-intercept of 5/3, an x-intercept of positive 5, and negative 1/2. We have two vertical asymptotes, one at x equals 1/2, and one at x equals negative 3. And we have a horizontal asymptote of y equals 1. So this graph does verify that our work is correct. I hope you found this helpful.